Hello and welcome. My name is Craig Bennett and I am the principal here at Indian Trail Junior High. In this segment, we are very excited to show you the opportunities that we afford our students on a daily basis. At Indian Trail, we implement the middle school concept of teaming, which allows our teachers to collaboratively work together to meet the needs of all of our students. Today, several representatives will take you on a guided tour of our school, highlighting the many opportunities that we have for our students. Those opportunities include our instructional co-teaching model, our Be Brave initiative, our connections classes, our clubs, activities, and athletic programs. I hope you enjoy your tour. Thank you. Hi, Mary. Congratulations on your award. What did you get awarded for?
I got $50 Project Pride for following the expectations at school.
Congratulations. Keep up the great work.
Thank you.
At Indian Trail, we are brave. We are respectful and value everyone.
In Connections, we learn expectations. We also listen to announcements, play games for good behavior.
So talking about leadership qualities, we're talking about what good student leaders do. So when you're filling out your form right now, we're thinking about, okay, who's inspired you to be responsible? Who's taught you how to have a positive attitude? Who's someone who helps you through obstacles, helps you through challenges? Who's taught you how to be clear when you're talking to people or looking at tasks? And who's taught you how to be organized? That's what we're filling out on our sheet. We're thinking about those types of people that really inspire you and that inspire you to be a good student leader.
This is the Indian Trail Library. The librarian posts pictures of kids who've read thousands of words. Indian Trail encourages kids to read as many books as they can during the school year. This is the fiction and nonfiction center of the library. This is where kids can check out books. There's a computer lab for classroom use.
Hi, Mary. It's good to see you. I came to check out a book for language arts class.
Cool. In language arts, we are encouraged to read our own books at our own individual levels. We also read in every other class as well.
Guys, be aware that some of your questions mean multiple things. If you're comparing, because he's comparing.
Many of our language arts classes have guided reading, in which the teacher or a co-teacher helps students or a group of students with their own individual reading goals. I also have co-teachers in other classes, like language arts, social science, and science as well, with either a supported education teacher or a teacher's aid. Can I go to the bathroom?
Sure.
Thank you.
All right, Esther, keep going.
I'll just take a room.
Hey, Heather, you're going to the game?
Yeah, I'll be sure to see you there.
Okay, cool.
Here at Indian Trail, physical education and athletics are a big part of our student activities. We make personal fitness goals based on our fitness level and interest. Our teachers like to introduce us to new ways of working out, like AMRAPs and Tabata training. We also have a fitness center and a spin room for PE use. Here in the Hall of Fame is where we display our accomplishments as a school. Some sports students can participate in are basketball, volleyball, cross country, track, and wrestling. But my personal favorite is volleyball because we were most successful in it.
To me, being brave is everybody working together in a group to achieve a common goal.
Being brave to me is standing up for what you believe in, even though it's hard to achieve.
Being brave to me means having confidence in yourself as a person and as a student.
Hi, I'm Kinnerin Vassos, and I'm the Student Council President at Indian Trail Junior High School. Student Council is an extracurricular club where students from 6th, 7th, and 8th grade join together to help brainstorm fundraising ideas and school events. As Student Council President, I continue to fight for justice and the equality of our student body. I will also assure you that I will find solutions for your concerns and keep Indian Trail Junior High School a safe and healthy environment.
Hello, my name is Lana Bastian, and
I am nominated by my teacher for Spirit Squad. My favorite thing about Spirit Squad is you get to make new friends and you get to socialize.
Hello, my name is Raul Gonzalez. I'm an 8th grade student here at Indian Trail Junior High. I participate in the wrestling club, and it's really fun because you get an outlet to everything. And if you're mad, you can use wrestling as an outlet, and it helps you with your homework, and it's really fun.
Hi, I'm Deanna Cantu, and I'm part of Project Pop. The best thing I like about Project Pop is that we help Indian Trail keep safe from bullying, and we promote kindness and positivity, and that's what it's all about.
Hi, I'm Casey Kosmack. I represent the art club at Indian Trail Junior High School, and I enjoy it because I get to express myself in different ways.
Hi, my name is Cindy Pham. I'm an 8th grader at Indian Trail Junior High. I participated in Girls on Track this year. It's a group where 6th, 7th, and 8th graders can join together and learn how to be confident in yourself and train for a 5K at the end of the year. My favorite part was running the 5K with my running buddy, who is my science teacher, and getting to know a lot of girls who are experiencing the same things that we are.
Hello, I'm representing the club IMSA Fusion. IMSA Fusion is a program from the Illinois Math and Science Academy. We do a lot of fun math and science experiments there, and it's a lot of hands-on things. Like we built a model of an airplane. And in the past, we made things like borax crystals, and we had a huge scavenger hunt throughout the school, and that was like my favorite part. I like IMSA because you can make many friends, and you work together as a team. And here is the borax crystal that we made.
Hi, my name is Anna Ruffalo, and I'm from the Indian Trail girls basketball team. Girls basketball was really fun this year because you get to make new friends and you learn to work together with other people.
Hi, my name is Michael Niemierski, and I am part of the Forest View Nursing Home Club. The reason why I like this club so much is because you can interact with people that have very interesting life stories.
Hi, my name is Abby Fakara, and I'm a 6th grader at Indian Trail Junior High School, and I'm a part of the Indian Trail Dance Crew. And what I love about it is that we come together as a crew, and we dance for about an hour, and it's so much fun, and I've made a lot of new friends from the dance crew.
Hi, my name is Nalia Rivera. I'm in 8th grade. I am a part of Yearbook Club here at Indian Trail. What I like about Yearbook Club is that you can interact with other kids from other grades and that you still have time to make friends at the same time when you're working on the yearbook, and you could see the yearbook before it is published.
Hi, my name is Sneha, and I'm representing Battle of the Books. One of my favorite things about Battle of the Books is getting new books to read and ideas to read them. My favorite part is making new friends and meeting new people.
Hi, my name is Liliana Guzman, and I am in 8th grade. I am part of SODA Club, which stands for Students Opposed to Drugs and Alcohol. And what I mostly like about it is how you do activities of what drugs and alcohol do to your body and how it affects it. And you learn all the types of drugs there is and what they do to you.
Hi, my name is Cantilla Villalobos. I'm an IT Achievers. I like this club because you do community service and like learn how to help out around your community.
Hello, I am Gianna Lessie, and I am a part of Drama Club. The reason I like Drama Club is because you get to interact with other students and I get to express my feelings. And it is always a privilege to be part of Drama Club. I love being a part of it.
Hi, my name is Abigail Estrada. I'm in Builders Club. And what we do in Builders Club is actually pretty fun with Mrs. Johnson and Mrs. Ryan. We made fleece blankets last time we came. They give out prizes. We have rewards if we behave. It's pretty cool being in Indian Trail with these clubs. I used to come to another school before I came here, and it's actually, I feel safe here than I used to in my other school. The teachers are very supportive over here, and I'm glad I came to Indian Trail. And I think to every teacher that helped me, and to the deans and to the office, that made a better school for me and to make me feel safe.
A picture-perfect lawn may look harmless, but its effects can be a real horror show. Rain washes fertilizer, bug and weed killers off your lawn, down ditches and drains, and into our rivers, where they can be toxic to wildlife and pollute our water. So cut back on lawn chemicals. Mow higher, leave the clippings, and enjoy a beautiful, healthy, safer lawn.
How do you feel about your commute these days? A little crabby? You can change that pretty easily. Just take Pace and feel happy as a clam. The savings will be a big change too. Travel in a more relaxing Pace.
My name is Dave Haas, and I am Public Information Officer for the DuPage County Health Department. It's my privilege to be here today and talk a little bit about a very important initiative that the Health Department has undertaken, and that's called FORWARD. And FORWARD is our anti-obesity initiative with the agency. We have many partners throughout DuPage County, and I'm really happy this morning that I am here with Crystal Kleinschmidt, who is an initiatives coordinator with the Health Department, specifically focusing on FORWARD, and she's going to tell us a little bit about that initiative. And I'm going to ask Crystal, first of all, thank her for being here.
Thank you.
And tell us a little bit about FORWARD and what you hope to accomplish as an initiative.
So FORWARD's been around for about 6 years now, and it has works through partnerships with the community, so through a coalition of well over 1,000 individuals and organizations. And we have the great support of the Health Department as our backbone fiduciary agent. So we are working to prevent and reduce obesity in DuPage County through increasing healthy eating and active living. So essentially, we want to make the healthy choice the easy choice within our county. So part of our goals involve making environmental systems and policy change so that it can be easy to make those healthy choices. So we're working in the future, we're going to keep working in schools, work sites, and early childhood centers. Additionally, we have a grant from the Illinois Department of Public Health. It's kind of called the Chronic Disease and School Health Grant. And that is allowing us to work in specific schools, early childhood centers, hospitals, on initiatives like I just mentioned. And we are really focusing our efforts with that grant in the Northeast region, in DuPage County, in the Addiscene area, Bensonville, Wooddale. So we're working with the school district in Addiscene, early childhood centers in Addiscene and Wooddale and Bensonville.
Well, that is really some terrific stuff, and I think people are impressed that there are over 1,000 people or organizations, partners mm-hmm. involved. It has really grown, I know, during the past 6 years. And each year you have done, or for the past few anyway, have done an anti-obesity report or a body mass index report, BMI report. And the most recent of those just came out, and it covers, and correct me if I'm wrong, but it's kindergarten, sixth and ninth grade students. Can you tell us a little bit about that report? And there's a significant finding that we want to talk about today regarding blood pressure. What was the result of that report? How many people are involved with the data collection?
Yeah, first let me share the report with everybody. This is what it looks like, and it's called Addressing Obesity in DuPage County, What You Can Do. So we really wanted it to be a call to action for the community, not just ourselves. And so it does cover kindergarten, sixth, and ninth grade, and we're talking near 30,000 students are involved in that data set. And we've been collecting this data for the last 5 years. So with those kindergarten, sixth, and ninth grade students, we found that 15.1% of them were obese. And as you mentioned, we collected blood pressure data this year. That was our first time doing that, so off of the school physical form. And what we saw was that of that 15.1% that were obese, 44% of them had an elevated blood pressure reading at the time of the school physical. So that was a little alarming to us to see that it was so high. Now granted, it's just one time at a school physical, so it's only one reading, but it is higher than what you see in some of the literature of what we might expect. And additionally, as we looked at children who were underweight to normal weight to overweight to obese, the percent that had an elevated blood pressure kept increasing until we got to that 44%. So showing us that it's not just what you see on the outside, those children, even at kindergarten, sixth and ninth grade, are already experiencing some of the health consequences of obesity mm-hmm. with elevated blood pressure.
And I think most of the adults who may be watching our program would say, well, I generally associate high blood pressure with adults, and to hear about it in children is probably somewhat concerning, alarming mm-hmm. to a lot of adults. Was there some reason that high blood pressure was added as an indicator during this recent survey?
Well, for one, it's something that was already on the school physical. We don't really have any other indicators that we could have picked from. Additionally, when you make changes like healthy eating and active living lifestyle changes, blood pressure is one of the first things that will change. Even before you start losing some of that body weight, your blood pressure can go down. So that was another reason that we indicated, or we mm-hmm. gathered that information this year.
And just in general, as we're talking about overweight and obesity, and I'm glad you kind of explained the underweight, at-weight, overweight and obesity, because I think that puts in perspective a little bit. What kind of are the obesity rates within DuPage County, and how does that compare to the rest of the nation just in general?
So one of the things we did new this year in our report was we looked at the obesity rates for children who were 2 to 4 year olds that were enrolled in the USDA's Special Nutritional Supplemental Program for women's infants and children, often called WIC. So we looked at that data set, and of those children, 20.4% were obese. So that kind of gives us that pre-kindergarten age for a subset of the population that are experiencing some low income. And then additionally, for our kindergartners, they had a 14.3% obesity rate. So when we look at those two data sets, if we compare those numbers to the United States, the United States rate was only 8.4%, so we're a little higher in there, really showing us that intervening earlier would be beneficial to bringing those rates down within DuPage County. Additionally, overall, like I said, our obesity rates for kindergarten, sixth and ninth grade were 15.1%. For the United States, that would cover those similar age ranges, we're looking at about 16.9. So we're below the U.S. in terms of our overall rates. Mm-hmm.
And when we talk about high blood pressure among that young audience, that young population, what are some of the things, some of the health issues or other, there are some other side issues that also can be a result among young people when they experience high blood pressure. What would be some of those things?
About what they might also experience with high blood pressure mm-hmm. or with obesity?
With high blood pressure.
Well, high blood pressure, often people don't even know they have it because you don't experience outward signs of it. So that's why it's good to get those annual physicals and have your doctor be checking that. But high blood pressure is one of the factors that leads to heart disease, which is the second leading cause of death in DuPage County. So really addressing high blood pressure is important.
And these kind of reports are something that is important to forward because it gives you some figures to compare to and see if you can actually make some improvement. And mm-hmm. that really is the goal, is to get some baseline figures and then you can track improvement. Is that right?
Yeah, we use it, and additionally, we want the county to know kind of where we are. We share those reports back with the schools and the school districts so they know where they are, so they can kind of use it as a gauge. Additionally, like I said earlier, we want to use it as a call to action for the community. So on the back page of the report, we list some steps that schools can take, early childhood centers, any employer, you know, local elected officials, healthcare, you know, steps that they can take too. So it's not, if each one of us takes some action steps, we could really see a lot of change within the county and hopefully lower those obesity rates.
And as we're talking, the report actually is focused on a young population, but some of the positive things that Forward suggests really apply to both children and adults? And what are some of the things that people can do to make themselves healthier?
That's a great question. So one of the things that we did, let me just pull this out. A few years ago, we adapted the 5-4-3-2-1 go message from CLOC. So CLOC is the Consortium to Lower Obesity in Chicago's Children. So they came up with this message quite a few years ago. And we have adapted it for use here in DuPage County. So as you can see here, it stands for 5 servings of fruits and vegetables a day, 4 servings of low-fat dairy, or 4 servings of water, 3 servings of low-fat dairy, 2 hours or less of screen time. So that's all that time on the computers and smartphones and things like that. And then to get 1 hour or more of physical activity each day. So this message is obviously has a look for children, but it would be very applicable for most adults too. Like, these are some positive things that almost any of us could pick one and really work on making some improvements in those areas.
Yeah, I think that that is excellent information that applies to both children and adults. So we've had the opportunity to kind of talk about what the situation is regarding children, but it's equally as important for adults. So if somebody is watching our program, where can they go for more information? I know Forward has some positive steps and information on the website. Where can people find more information?
Yeah, so our website is forwarddupage.org, and we do have on there some of those action steps that I talked about that are on the back of the report. There's even more details and links on our website for different sectors that are interested in resources. And then we also are on Facebook and Twitter.
All right, thank you very much, Crystal. We sure appreciate the opportunity to talk a little bit about Forward and its anti-obesity campaign throughout DuPage County. My name is Dave Haas, and with me today was Crystal Kleinschmidt, and I thank her for her time.
Dear Mom, I don't know how to start saying something like this. I'm so sorry. I shouldn't have gone to the party. I've entered a world I don't want to be a part of. I'm in hell, Mom. A nightmare, and I need you to help me. I'm so afraid it's too late. Everything spiraled out of control. I want to be your little girl again. I love you, Mom, and I don't know where to turn.
Dear baby girl, I wish I could have helped you. You would have never done anything, ever, for me to hate you. I just wish I could hold you in my arms and tell you it's all going to be okay, that we can just go back to the way it was. I love you, and I'd do anything to hold you in my arms one more time. Love, your mom.
Intergalactic destiny. I'm ready, as we all must be, to take on this crazy meteoric conflict. Yikes!
Watch a movie on the way to work. Can't do this driving, but you can on Pace. Pace turns any commute into moments of relaxation. Travel in a more relaxing pace.
First of all, on behalf of everyone involved with the Addiscene Chamber of Commerce, thank you for being here. Give yourselves a round of applause. Thank you for being here for our annual meeting and the mayor's address. This is kind of a special year, the beginning of a special year for the Addiscene Chamber of Commerce. This is our 25th year in our present form, and we're hoping that we're just getting started. And with your help, maybe we'll look back on that 25th anniversary as when we were moving from, you know, point A and we're at point C, D, M, or Q, or something like that down the road. So that's certainly the ambition of all of us that are involved with the chamber. I'd like to, we have a little bit of business briefly. I know we're all here really to hear the state of the address from Mayor Veenstra, We have a couple of pieces of business to do for the chamber, and we'll get those quickly in front of you and out of the way. First of all, I do have to do a couple of shameless plugs, so bear with me. It's commercial time. The first shameless plug is that we have our annual Five Star Expo. The Five Star Expo is coming up on Friday, February 5th. It's going to be at the Medina Shrine Center, and it's a great show every year. A lot of interesting displays from a wide variety of businesses in the area, including Addison. So come and join us. It's a good time, and it's kind of an educational time. We really see some great things that are going on from the businesses in our community. So that's on Friday, February 5th. We hope to see you for that. The other shameless plug that I'm going to do is, some of you may be aware, I catch this in the news every once in a while. I think there's kind of some rumor about a political drama going on in the state of Illinois. Is there something going on with that? I have a hard time keeping my hands on that. In the midst of that ongoing drama, we're delighted, and I especially thank Dee LaRocca for helping make this happen. In conjunction with some other local chambers, we're going to have Governor Bruce Rauner here. We're going to have him at Venuti's Banquets, and that's going to be at 8 o'clock for a breakfast meeting on Monday, February 8th. So we urge you to try to carve out that time early that day, get your week off to an early start, and we'll hear what the governor has to say about what's happening or maybe what's not happening these days in Illinois. So we'll be very excited about welcoming the governor to Addison on that day. We're going to be presenting the program with Governor Rauner in conjunction with the Bartlett, Hanover Park Chamber, Carroll Stream, Elmhurst, Lombard, Roselle, and the Villa Park Chamber. So we'll probably have a lot of folks in attendance to hear what Mr. Rauner has to say that day. Thank you again all for being here. And before we go into the formal part of our program, would you please rise and join me in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I'd like to welcome our elected officials that have joined us today. Of course, as we anticipate his State of the Village address, we have Mayor Rich Veenstra. Mayor, thank you for being here. We also have two members of the Addison Village Board, two trustees with us today, Sylvia Lane and Harry Theodore. Stand up, take a bow. Thank you for being here. From the Addison Fire Protection District, we have trustees Michael Super and Dee LaRocca. From DuPage School District 88, Donna Kraft Kane. Is Donna here? I guess she couldn't make it. Okay. Addison School District 4, we have Dave Williams. Dave. And from the Addison Park District, Tina Towns. Something that I always especially enjoy at any of our luncheon meetings is when we have a new chamber member. First of all, we have a new chamber member. That's really always great news. But we also like to give the opportunity for them to do a shameless plug for their business, to get off on the right foot with the Addison Chamber. So I'm very pleased to announce our newest member. It's Jenna DeFalco of J.C. Licht, and Jenna's going to tell us a little bit more about her business. Jenna?
Decorators.
Great. Well, welcome, and thank you for that update. The official business that we have to do is our annual meeting. Now, I'm sure those of you who were here last January have a very detailed recall of what transpired at that meeting. The minutes for that meeting are actually on page 2 of the program that we put together today. But we do have to get a motion and then hopefully an approval of those minutes. So if somebody has, you know, one of those minds that just remembers every single word that came out, you might be able to help us with that. But there's a good summary of the meeting, and I'd like a motion from the floor in a second for us to approve those minutes from our annual meeting of a year ago. It's a procedural thing we need to take care of. Do I have a motion? Patty makes a motion and a second. Tim DeLauder with a second. And do I hear an approval for those minutes of the annual meeting a year ago? Aye? Thank you. Any nays? Good. We're off to a good start. As far as this year's annual meeting is concerned, we have three positions that we similarly need a motion and a second to approve, and then your vote on that. We have a new director for your consideration, and that is Barbara Lazara. And for a continued term, a second term, in two of our officer positions, we have Sari Levy as vice president, and myself, Bob Anderson, as president. Do I have a motion and a second to approve that slate for your consideration today? Okay, Joe Leon, and who else? And Marcy. So we have a motion. Do we have a vote? All in favor? Opposed? Come on, a couple of you. Come on, a couple of you. The motion carries. Thank you very much. Mayor Veenstra, would you please join me up here, and Barbara and Sari, would you please come up as well for the swearing in?
Okay, if you would raise your right hand. I state your names.
I, Bob Anderson.
Sari Levy.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States of America.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States of America.
And the Constitution of the State of Illinois.
And the Constitution of the State of Illinois.
And that I will faithfully discharge the duties of the office of.
I will faithfully.
Vice President.
President.
According to the best of my abilities.
According to the best of my abilities.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor. Okay, Barbara and Sari, we have you hooked for at least another year, so, okay. And now the part of the meeting that I'm sure we're anticipating more than anything else. I look forward to this. I've been coming to these for a long time, and it's really great to get such a comprehensive update about the Village of Addiscene, so I'm excited that it's going to happen again right now. Mayor Veenstra has served as mayor of Addiscene now since April of 2014, after many years of service to the Village of Addiscene as a village trustee and more. Since taking office, Rich has instituted many new ideas and activities to the great benefit of our community. We're pleased to have Mayor Veenstra as our keynote speaker today to provide us with an update and hopefully some ideas about what can we look forward to in these exciting times for the Village of Addiscene. So again, Mayor Veenstra.
Thank you. Thank you, Bob. And I want to thank the Chamber for giving me the opportunity to speak about the Village of Addiscene. It's always a real pleasure for me to do this, especially when the Village has had another very good year. We've continued to be financially stable, and we continue to see renewed interest in commercial, industrial, and residential development. Progress continues to be made in improving the quality of life for our residents. In the area of finance, our bond rating, which is critical in securing the most favorable credit rates, was reaffirmed as AA+, due in large part to the diligent work of our staff in maintaining a fiscally responsible operation while maintaining high quality service levels. We were able to refund two existing bond issues, resulting in the savings to the Village of $850,000 over the next 10 years. Video gaming has added another $150,000 to our tax revenue. This additional revenue is specifically designated to support community events such as Rock and Wheels and other venues designed to increase community spirit and involvement. In the area of community development, as was the case last year, we've had some wins, some delays, and a few changes. JetBright Car Wash completed its upgrade several weeks ago and can now boast of the newest state-of-the-art facility in the area. And while the owner of the Lake Street Commons Center was unable to close the deal with Export to anchor the center, significant improvement to the center's appearance has been made, including facade and parking lot restoration, and most recently, the demolition of the old Fannie Mae's building. Several new businesses have opened in the center, including AutoZone, with at least two additional restaurants scheduled to open in the very near future. The renovation and expansion of the former mobile gas station on the corner of Lake and 53 was to be completed in 2014 and then delayed to 2015. Issues with wetlands, design changes, and garnering required agency approvals have continued to slow the project, but we've been told construction is scheduled to begin in early spring of 2016. On the east side of town, we've seen dramatic changes to the old JC Plaza. Under new ownership, full facade improvement, as well as downsizing of the vacant John's restaurant, has been completed. A new 60,000 square foot building to be located to the east of the old restaurant will be under construction this spring. This addition will provide new restaurants and retail space and will help drive the revitalization of the center. The vacant dental profile building was purchased by First Family Dental and will become a new dental office as well as the corporate headquarters for a 12-office dental chain after undergoing a facelift, or more precisely, a roof lift, that will upgrade the integrity of the building and provide a more complementary appearance to JC Plaza. Popeye's long-awaited teardown of the former Taco Bell building will be underway in early spring, and ATI, the physical rehab company, completed the renovation of the old KFC building and is now open for business. Both Burger King and McDonald's have invested significant dollars in upgrading their buildings. While Caputo's $3.5 million expansion has been delayed due to budgetary constraints, we've been told the project is still online and is expected to begin this year. It will include full facade upgrade of the plaza and expansion of the current store to provide similar amenities as the newer Caputo stores. The old Sims clothing store has been totally renovated and recently reopened as a 1,500-seat Shalimar banquet facility. There were, if there were a disappointment this past year in terms of retail revival, it would be the Centennial Plaza, which continues to be a pain point in terms of vacancies. While the new ownership continues to explore options, no firm commitments have been made. The bottom line, though, is that we're seeing reinvesting, renovation, and new businesses coming to much of our Lake Street corridor. This trend will continue, and I'm confident that it will ultimately include Centennial Park. On the manufacturing and industrial front, we continue to boast of the fourth largest industrial park in the state and are experiencing a robust 95% occupancy rate. Perhaps the biggest and most common challenge to the sector is maintaining a skilled workforce and finding qualified candidates to fill vacancies. To that end, we have initiated an exploratory task force comprised of representatives from Addison Trail High School, the Technology Center of DuPage, the College of DuPage, the Illinois Manufacturers Association, the Technology and Manufacturing Association, and business owners from our industrial area, whose goals are to identify job-specific training needs, develop curriculum to meet those identified needs, provide training and career paths for first-generation adults and for students that are not college-bound, to provide a qualified and reliable labor pool for our manufacturers, and to improve the overall economic level of our community. On the residential side, project starts that we had hoped to see last fall were delayed but are still moving forward. We're continuing to explore potential senior living center options at several locations and are awaiting final plans for the townhome development on Rolling Road at Woodland. The single-family residential development to be located at the old Addison Golf Course property is expected to begin construction the latter part of this year. In terms of infrastructure improvement, the Illinois Environmental Protection Agency Low Interest Loan Phase 1 project was completed at a cost of nearly $9 million. The work included replacement of 6 sanitary lift stations and upgrades to the A.J. LaRocca and North Wastewater Treatment Plants. Under our motor fuel tax street program, 7 miles of streets were replaced, as was the Iowa Street water main from Armitage to Sydney, for a total of $3.3 million, $700,000 of which came from community development block grants. Under the FEMA buyout program, 8 flood-prone residential properties were acquired, with the goal of acquiring 9 more for a total cost of $4.5 million in federal funding. Knowing the popularity of the community events that are held on the municipal campus, as well as the drainage problems that have plagued the Village Green for years, we completed phase 1 of our Village Green project that will provide stormwater drainage and infrastructure that will facilitate the expansion of our summer events programs and also will provide more amenities for our residents. In terms of quality of life, both for residents as well as for businesses, a safe community is essential. It's the Village's responsibility to provide that safe environment. Programs that have been initiated or supported by our police department are a cornerstone of that effort. Our crime-free housing program continues to be a model for communities in DuPage County. Because of efficiencies derived from our well-developed workflow and staffing patterns, our consolidated dispatch center is able to provide services far exceeding those of the countywide system. Because of those efficiencies, we currently provide dispatch services to Bensonville, Itasca, Wooddale, Bloomingdale, the County Forest Preserve, and we'll be adding Glendale Heights May 1st. Several fire districts are also considering using our dispatch center, as well as 2 additional communities. In light of the continuing national controversy involving police and police tactics, it's important to note that we have been utilizing a policing model that's built on relationships, a people-centric model. Our police department is there for our community. This is reflected in the recent actions of the Commission on Accreditation of Law Enforcement Agencies in recertifying our police department with their gold standard accreditation with meritorious distinction, an honor and recognition that is given to less than 1% of police agencies throughout the world. The O'Hare expansion continues to cause significant challenges to many communities, including Addison. We are one of 11 municipalities that are members of the Suburban O'Hare Commission. Because O'Hare is truly the economic engine for our region, we support its expansion and plans for completing Western Access, but actively oppose any changes made without considering the remediation of increased noise levels due to those changes. We've been working together with state legislators, DuPage and Cook County officials, as well as various community groups to fix solutions that minimize the impact on our communities and to protect the quality of life for all of our residents. I'm happy to report that after many frustrating years of contention with the airport authorities and the FAA, progress is being made in developing policies that will mitigate those noise and safety concerns of our residents, but there's still a lot of work that needs to be done. Technology and transparency remain a focus as we continue to add communication portals that provide two-way communication with our residents and those visiting or working in town. Robust access points such as AddisonAdvantage.org, ItHappensInAddison.com, our online e-newsletter, Facebook and Twitter accounts provide quick sources of information to the community. Our Code Red message system, used to announce impending emergency situations, continues to be one of the most effective tools in providing early warning to our residents. And the addition this year of the Addison Connect app allows our residents to identify problems in the community and immediately notify the proper municipal department of the issue with just a few clicks of their smartphone. Addison is unique in its resources, location, and spirit that is unmatched by other communities. Our various governmental agencies, service organizations, members of our business community, and church groups individually do remarkable things, but we are a community, and that suggests collaborative action and involvement that promote the common good as well as the individual good. Over the past year, we have again seen remarkable results when groups work together to achieve their individual goal as well as to help build community. Memorial Day continues to grow as a major collaborative event for our community. Our Church Leadership Council, composed of pastors of local churches, brought their individual congregations together to celebrate an interfaith Thanksgiving service, to participate in a live nativity scene the night of our tree lighting, to celebrate an evening of prayer for unity, and to participate in food and clothing drives for less fortunate of our village. In February, they will again co-host a dinner, bringing together families of various ethnic backgrounds to discuss and explore ways to unite all segments of our community and to erase the divides brought about by cultural and language differences. This past year, we celebrated the 25th anniversary of the Mayor's Charity Ball, which represents 20 charitable organizations in Addison. Over 530 members of the community were in attendance, and $62,000 was raised for those charities. This brings the total raised by the Mayor's Ball since its inception to $936,000. I invite all of you to join us in this year's drive to make it a million by participating in our November 12th Mayor's Charity Ball. Again, working together with various community groups and organizations, we saw over 10,000 attendees at our Rock and Wheels Summer Event Concert and Food Fest events. The reemergence of community spirit and pride was clearly evident at each event, and the local business sponsors gained significant exposure through radio, cable, print, online publicity. And actually, at your tables, if you're interested in becoming a sponsor, there's information for you, and you can speak to Don Weiss after today's presentation on ways of becoming a sponsor for our Rock and Wheels events. Marketing is a key factor in building image and awareness. To that end, we recruited a small group of businesses and developed a marketing strategy designed to focus on all of Addison's recreational opportunities, as well as highlighting those individual businesses under the banner of the Addison Advantage. In conjunction with radio station 95.9 The River, several local businesses that agreed to participate in our community relations department developed the Dine, Play, and Stay promotion, a 12-month engagement that provides on-air promotion as well as internet links. We hosted the first Addison Home Improvement Expo in the Village Hall Rotunda last February, giving local home improvement retailers and contractors an opportunity to showcase their businesses to our residents. Our second annual event, Expo, will be held at the Rotunda of the Village Hall on March 11th and March 12th. As we continue to see a lack of responsiveness from Springfield to the needs of local municipalities, it becomes more critical than ever to work closely with other local governmental organizations and agencies in developing a unified message and a strong voice in pursuing positive outcomes for our communities. Addison continues to work closely with Chicago Metropolitan Agency for Planning in developing long-range plans for growth and development that are consistent with our region. We also maintain strong involvement with the DuPage Mayors and Managers Conference, the Illinois Municipal League, and other organizations that can speak with a common voice to achieve our regional needs. As I first said, this has been a very good year for Addison, and much has been accomplished, but as always, there is much more to do. To stay ahead of the curve, to be on the forefront of innovation, and to continue to grow all sectors of our community, we need to remember that we are in a highly competitive race with other communities. And just as a highly tuned race car requires all of its components to work together to generate peak performance, we as independent governmental organizations and entities must work together in conjunction with our residents and our businesses to maximize our resources, our talents, and our efforts to give Addison the competitive advantage to lead and not to follow other communities. The future of Addison is and will continue to be bright as long as we together recognize our individual value and just as importantly, recognize the power and advantage of working together with all elements of our community. For only in that unity and spirit of cooperation can we fully realize the Addison Advantage. Thank you very much. If there are any questions, I'd be happy to address them. Okay, very good. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mayor. Obviously, it's been a good year. And I'll help you with your shameless plug. So you said the Mayor's Ball is going to be on November 12th. Okay, mark it down, November 12th. Dee mention something that was pretty important to me that I want to convey to you. When I did my shameless plug a little while ago about the governor coming here on Monday, February 8th for an 8 a.m. breakfast meeting, we're on a real tight timetable for that. We were just able to confirm his being here a day or two ago, so we're working with a real narrow window. If you want to reserve your place, please let Dee at the chamber office know by Tuesday, right, of next week, so that we definitely have the spot reserved for you for the following Monday, February 8th. So we don't want you to miss out if that's something you would like to put onto your agenda. The last piece of business we have is a $30 split the pot. So I need some help in picking a random winner here. Mayor, I'll have you do the honors. Three, six, 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 three, three. Do we have a winner? Let me say it again. 366-633. You got it. Thank you, everyone. Thank you for being here. Hope to see you soon.